Former Papillion Mayor James Blinn left office in a cloud of controversy. Allegations of an inappropriate relationship with a city employee led to her suing and the city paying $200,000. Well, that Papillion payout triggered a change in state law and is the backdrop for the November election. In our Commitment 2010 report, meet the two men who want to be mayor.
What caught my attention was the Mayor Blinn situation.
And Terry Brennan didn't like it. So he says he wants to bring integrity and transparency to City Hall.
Without that, I don't know how much trust or how much you can believe in your elected officials.
Brennan, who has experience in real estate and insurance, wants to ensure that the city keeps its local flavor.
I'd like to see Papillion maintain its rich heritage, its small town feel. I think that's what brings a lot of people here.
People want a safe place to live, they want a fair value, and they want a sense of community.
David Black, who was sworn in as mayor last year, agrees, but says Papillion needs to keep growing, he says, by encouraging entrepreneurship.
If we have a vibrant small business community and then periodically we get a big win on the large-scale economic development, I don't think we can beat that.
Some of the development could be along Highway 370, where the new Sarpy County Baseball Stadium's going in. Right now, it's outside city limits. But neither candidate wants Papillion to rush into anything.
Growth for growth's sake, I don't think does anybody any good.
When it financially makes sense, we'll annex it.
Both men also speak in football metaphors. Black talking about the city's economic outlook.
That last 10 years was our first half. We had a great first half. But that's not what the second half's going to look like, and we've got to finish strong.
And Brennan, who's considered a long shot, talking about his political outlook.
In football vernacular, I'm in the fourth quarter down by 50. I'm certainly not going to lay down. I've come this far. I'm going to keep on trying.
Now, in the primary, Black took 87% of the vote. Brennan had 8%.